Hello everyone, you're watching OdishaTV.in with me, Subhojit Panda. First up, let's have a quick look at the top 5 stories making headlines from the state of Odisha. Martyred CRPF Jawan Pradeep Panda consigned to flames in Sundargarh. Marriage processions on 5 routes banned in Bhubaneswar to ease traffic movement. Duty call-up allowance of home guards hiked in Odisha. Curtain comes down on Bargad Dhanujatra with the symbolic death of tyrannical king Kansa. And Anurag Sarangi to lead Odisha cricket team for Syed Mushtaq Ali T20 cricket tournament. Now the news in details. Martyred CRPF Jawan Pradeep Panda, who was killed in a fierce gun battle with militants in Jammu and Kashmir on Sunday, was consigned to flames today. Earlier, a guard of honour was given after the body of the martyred Jawan reached his native village at Liploi in Sundargarh district. A massive crowd had gathered to witness the event. The area reverberated with Shahid Pradeep Panda Amar Rahe slogans as over 10,000 people gathered at the Rajgangpur Stadium to pay last respect to the Jawan. The commissioned police on Tuesday banned marriage processions on 5 major arterial routes of the city in order to ease traffic movement, ensure smooth passage to essential services and reduce inconvenience to commuters during the processions. Police sources said from 1st of February, major arterial routes like New Airport Crossing to Acharya Vihar via AG Square, Raj Bhavan Square to Kit Square, Kalpana Square to Raj Bhavan Square, Bani Vihar to Sishu Bhavan Square and Katak Road to Rasulgarh Square would remain off-limits for wedding revelers during processions. The move comes following a report by DCP Traffic that marriage processions lead to congestion on the main roads, hampering smooth flow of traffic and preventing commuters from reaching destinations such as railway station, bus stops, airport as well as hospitals on time. Odisha government on Tuesday enhanced the duty call-up allowance of home guards across the state. A notification was issued by the Home Department in this regard, which said that the home guards will now get Rs. 300 as duty call-up allowance a day, as against the earlier amount of Rs. 240 per day. There are about 20,000 home guards working on a daily basis in the state. The home guards were on agitation demanding increasing in the remuneration and demanded regular appointment in police. A bus carrying around 45 passengers fell off a bridge near Barani in Balesur district on late Tuesday night, leaving 10 injured. Police said all the injured were admitted to district headquarters hospital and those who sustained minor injuries were discharged after first aid. The state government-run OSRTC bus was coming from Puri via Bhubaneswar yesterday, carrying 45 tourists, mostly from West Bengal. It later fell off the bridge due to rash driving. The wildlife wing of the Odisha Forest Department today began the annual bird census in Chilika, Asia's largest brackish water lagoon, and in several other wetlands under different wildlife sanctuaries in the state. Forest Department sources said as many as 21 teams with 5 members each, comprising officials of wildlife organizations, several ornithologists, wildlife activists and bird lovers of the state are participating in the bird counting at Chilika, Balugaon, Satpada, Tangi and Rambha range under Khorda Forest Division and Brahmagiri and Nuapada range under Puri Forest Division. Taking stern note of rise in incidents of malpractice during matriculation examination, especially in rural areas, the Board of Secondary Education has decided to strengthen security and invigilation systems for the annual high school certificate examination this time. A 3-tier security system will be put in place to keep a vigil on the examination centres during the matriculation examination starting from 23rd February in Odisha. As per sources, the BSC will seek help of district collectors and SPs to beef up security measures near examination centres. Besides, stern action will also be taken against students involved in malpractice during the exam.
ଏବଂ ପ୍ରତିଟି ସେଣ୍ଟର ପ୍ରତିଟି ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ୱାଇଜ୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ୱାଇଜ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟର ଯେଉଁ ହୋଇଛି ତା ଉପରେ ଆମର ସ୍କ୍ୱାଡ୍ର ଟିମ୍ ଗଠନ କରାଯିବ ଏବଂ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲି ମନିଟର କରିବାର ବନ୍ଦୋବସ୍ତ କରୁଛୁ କୌଣସି ପ୍ରକାରର ମାଲ୍ ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିସ୍ ବା କୌଣସି ଅନିୟମିତତା ଆମେ ବରଦାସ୍ତ କରିବୁ ନାହିଁ ୟା ଏଥିପାଇଁ ଆମର ସରକାର ଏବଂ ଯେଉଁ ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେସନ୍ ଅଛନ୍ତି କଲେକ୍ଟର ଏସ୍ପି ସମସ୍ତେ ସହଯୋଗ କରିବେ
Odisha's hope for a hike in paddy MSP was dashed after the centre in the parliament yesterday ruled out chances of an increase, citing that the government is already providing adequate margins to farmers. In a written reply, Union Minister of State for Agriculture Gajendra Singh Shekhawat said that the centre has fixed the paddy MSP at ₹1,550 for 2017-18 financial year, which provides a profit margin of ₹433 per quintal over all India weighted average cost of production of ₹1,117 per quintal as estimated by the Commission for Agricultural Costs and Prices. In his reply, the Union Minister also stated that the MSPs fixed by the government provides adequate returns over all India weighted average costs of production, and so there is no proposal to change the formula for determining MSPs at present.
ভাল ভাবে তাকে তর্জমা করু না তা মধ্যে এইভাবে এক টিপ্পণী কি মু নাপসন্দ করুছি পুঁ কৃষক জাতি পাই ইয়ে এক চরম অবহেলা
পার্লামেন্টে যে বক্তব্য দিয়েছেন বিজেপি দলর মন্ত্রী সেতু স্পষ্ট জনা পড়ুছি যে বিজেপি দল এবং কেন্দ্র সরকার ওড়িশার চাষী সমাজ প্রতি বিশ্বাসঘাতকতা করেছেন বেইমানি করেছেন
ইয়ে যেতবে এমএসপি কথা উঠুছি সর্বভারতীয় স্তরের ইয়ে কথা আছে আড়িশা কু কেন্দ্র অবহেলা করুচি এমএসপি দেলানি একথা কহিকি নিজ দোষক কাই খসাই দৌঁছেন
ইউনিয়ন পেট্রোলিয়াম মিনিষ্টার ধর্মেন্দ্র প্রধান ইয়েস্টারডে এক্সপ্রেসড হোপ দ্যাট দ্য রুলিং বিজেডি ইন ওড়িশা উইল সাপোর্ট দ্য ট্রিপল তালাক বিল ইন দ্য রাজ্যসভা. Citing that a few MPs of the BJD had opposed the bill in Lok Sabha, Dharmendra Pradhan said that the party which preaches development of women should rise above the shallow mindset and vote for the triple talaq bill in Rajya Sabha. On the other hand, BJD said that it has never opposed the bill. Instead, it wants some lacuna to be addressed. The Odisha State Pollution Control Board has now geared up to crack whip on defaulting hoteliers who are yet to deposit penalty for flouting pollution norms in the pilgrim city of Puri. Official sources said a list of defaulters is now being prepared and the process to seal the hotels is likely to start from January end or the first week of February 2018. As per norms, hoteliers are required to obtain consent to establish and consent to operate certificates from OSPCB under the Water Prevention and Control Act 1974 before setting up hotels in Odisha. A woman who was undergoing treatment at Nayagarh District Headquarters Hospital was allegedly molested by the warden of Nayagarh Sub-Jail, Ramakrishna Sahu, and his friend. The matter came to light after the family of the victim lodged a complaint in connection with the incident with Nayagarh Town Police on Tuesday. According to reports, the accused warden and one of his friends in an inebriated condition allegedly misbehaved with the woman who was undergoing treatment at the hospital. Despite reports of crop loss due to drought, unseasonal rain and pest attacks, there would be bumper paddy production in Odisha this year. Confirming the development, Food Supplies and Consumer Welfare Minister Surya Narayan Patra on Tuesday stated that already 30% excess paddy has been procured so far in the state. Nearly 14.32 lakh metric tons of paddy have already been procured from 2,32,075 registered farmers in the state. A joint team of Civil Supplies and Weights and Measures departments and police yesterday raided two petrol pumps in Sambalpur over alleged fuel theft by using electronic chips. Sambalpur SDPO Mihir Panda said that the following complaints of fuel pilferage, the team inspected the fuel dispensing machines at Modipada and Kullukakhani in the town. Besides, the squad also verified whether any electronic chip was installed in the machines to manipulate the display of quantity of fuel transferred to a customer. The famous Dhanujatra of Bargad in Odisha, believed to be the largest open-air theatre in the world, concluded yesterday with the death of tyrannical King Kansa and coronation of Ugrasena. During the 11-day festival that kicked off on 23rd December, Bargad town was made to resemble Mathura, the birthplace and homeland of Lord Krishna. The festival is based on Krishna Leela and Mathura Vijay. Left-handed batsman Anurag Sarangi has been named as the captain of the 15-member Odisha squad for the upcoming East Zone Syed Mushtaq Ali T20 cricket tournament. Keunchar batsman Subranshu Senapati will be his deputy in this competition in the absence of senior members like Govind Poddar, Biplav Samantrai and Vasant Mahanti. The team includes many young faces along with a few seniors like Paresh Patel, Lagnajit Samal and Jan Behra, who are making a comeback in the Odisha team. Rajasthan Royals all-rounder Abhishek Raut has been selected in the Odisha team for the first time. Former India opener Shiv Sundar Das, who was appointed as the chief coach during Ranji Trophy, will continue in this tourney as well. Like many tribal sportsperson from Odisha, rugby player Munda Murmu has also brought laurels to the state. He was recently selected in the Indian team for the Asian Rugby Championship held in Taiwan. OdishaTV.in reporter caught up with the player in Bhubaneswar. Here's a report.
Hailing from a primitive tribal community of Odisha has not deterred Munda Murmu from scaling new highs in the sporting arena. He has been making the state proud for last 4 years by representing Team India in senior rugby tournaments. Playing a game which is not that popular in India, he has been consistently performing well for the national side. Born in a Santal family at Chudanga in Khurda district, Munna first came to Kalinga Institute of Social Sciences or KISS in Bhubaneswar as a class 5 student and showed inclination towards athletics. He got into playing rugby professionally after being inspired by the KISS team's victory in the Under 14 Rugby World Cup held in London in 2007.
2007 mosiya re thore bahar foreigner asile ki campus re sete bele जो फॉरेनर माने आसीले कि से माने कहि कि गले जो माने ए खेल रे 14 रो थिला गोटे मैच करथिले आ जो माने ए खेल रे भलो परफॉर्मेंस करबो से माने बाहर फॉरेन टूर को जिवो तो सेते बेड को मोर अंडर 14 रो गोटे मासो एज बढ़ जायथिला कि मु से अंडर 14 टीम रे मु पाई परली नै तापर अंडर 14 2007 रे जेते बेड हम जूनियर अंडर 14 रो बॉयज माने हमर इंग्लैंड जाय चैंपियन हे आसीले तो मोर सेठू टिके इंटरेस्ट बढ़िला कि मो सांगो माने से माने जाय बाहर फॉरेन रे जाय जीति के आसीले आ मु भी केमती टिके बाहर को जिबी आ भलो खेड़ीबी.
After his solid performance in the under 16 national tournament, he was selected for the Indian under 19 team in 2010. He gives credit to Rudrakesh Jena, the then coach and currently assistant sports director of KISS, for his success at various international competitions. He seems satisfied with his life and feels blessed to see a smile on his parents' face after his success.
3 years mo jete bele fast jaithile Laos setere bahut khushi heithile ebe bi mu jete bele jae माँ को आसिक कहे माँ तो किसी पाठ साठ पढ़े ना पेपर भी जाए ना टीवी भी नाई घरे एबे आम घरे लाइन आसला से लाइन फाइन किसी ना आम बापा किसी जानती कि भाई जिते मार्केट को जानती बाजार को जानती सांग मैंने कहती पेपर पेपर बाहरी थाए तो माँ को आखाती तो माँ बहुत खुशी हूँ.
After making his senior international debut in 2013, Munna is a permanent winger in the side. KISS has appointed him as a rugby coach after he completed his post-graduation in political science from KIT University this year. He is now busy in guiding the young rugby players of the institution, many of whom have now played international tournaments in the junior category.
He has better experience. He represented India 4 times. So now we are using his talent to by coaching to our junior students. So we think his knowledge, his experience will help us.
Munai ko jeta ame coach bagya re dekhuchu amara tankaro tanko je sikhuchu tanko bahut improve hoichi jaha pore ma ji utolam be qualify mo participation kori parche
jehetu sie bahut puruna player amara तो बहुत पूर्वर से माने रग्बी स्टार्ट करथिले एवं से माने जे जो लेवल पर्यंत पहुँची चंती बहुत परिश्रम करके पहुँची चंती एवं खाली से नुहे सी आमको बर्तमान कोचिंग मध्ये देउचंती जहाँ से माने जेते बेले को बाहर को इंडिया कैंप करने जाती से माने जो बाहर आम इंडिया रो कोच अछन जे तांको ट्रेनिंग दियंती से मानको जहाँ सीखी के आसी थांती आमको से मध्ये सिखाई थांती.
Son of a farmer, Munna Murmu's story is certainly an inspiration for many. After his individual success, Munna is now dedicated to the team's performance and also wants to produce more and more international rugby players from the state. From Bhubaneswar, Chiranjeevi Pati, OdishaTV.in.
Before wrapping up, a quick look at the headlines once again. Martyred CRPF Jawan Pradeep Panda consigned to flames in Sundargarh. Marriage processions on 5 routes banned in Bhubaneswar to ease traffic movement. Duty call-up allowance of home guards hiked in Odisha. Curtain comes down on Bargad Dhanu Jatra with the symbolic death of tyrannical king Kansa. And Anurag Sarangi to lead Odisha cricket team for Syed Mushtaq Ali T20 cricket tournament. That's all for today. For more news and updates, please log on to our website www.odishatv.in. Thanks for watching.